has had a pretty fine tournament here also. The Aggies in the dark uniforms, the Hornets in white, and the Hornets control the tent. Greg Oes gives it off to Clayton Harris, 6 foot senior. Harris over to Oes. Hornets working it around. This is Loader. Fedica the rebound, and here come the Aggies. From left to right across your screen, King to Jackson on the move. Jackson double team momentarily. Franklin from the foul line. Up high, Mel Creighton and Alabama State back the other way in a hurry. On the drive, Harris. Harris double team momentarily. Oes in the corner, thought better of the shot. Now he's got some room on Fedica. Nice move. Down low on the rebound, it won't go inside for Forster, and a foul's called. Forston inside forced the play. We'll get another look at it.
You see Forston going up for the ball. That's two rebounds. Alabama State's got one under the offensive board, and that's going to be a big factor tonight in this ball game. We can get those offensive boards.
Ray Franklin guilty of the first foul of the ball game. Hornets on the attack. Inside. Forston, good fake on Franklin. Nice move. Won't go. Jackson the rebound.
Leroy Jackson has been controlling the boards pretty much for Cameron, and that's going to be a big key for the Aggies tonight. If Jackson can play tough on the boards again.
Aggies on the attack. Wilson baseline. Loaders out on Jackson. King works from the point. Vanderman defense being employed by the Hornets. Down low, Franklin has a move. The final score of 2-0. Half a minute into this first half of play. Aggies pressing the backcourt. Oes double team. Wilson comes away with it. Jeff Wilson had it parked off the bottom of the backcourt, knocked out of bounds. And it was last touched by the Hornets, so it will be Aggie basketball.
Let's take another look at it. You see the Aggies with the full court press. Jeff Wilson finally gets a hand on it. That was Andre King getting a hand in there. Wilson going all the way down, and Gregory Oes did a good job of getting back on defense to break up the play.
You're watching Dave Fedica at the point. Wilson on the left wing. Franklin up high. Fedica on the right side. Franklin with his Harris. King chasing down the errant pass. Franklin has the step on Forston. Inside of Jackson and a foul call. The first of the ball game on Alabama State.
We'll take another look at it. I believe Melvin Creighton got called for the foul. You see Franklin with the feet inside to Leroy Jackson. That's Creighton on the arm. He got charged with the foul.
So Leroy Jackson, 42 total points in this tournament at the foul line. He's made 30 of 38 tries. Hit eight in a row in his coming foul. Cameron lays it 3-0. Make it 4-0 Aggie. Hornets will receive pressure in the backcourt, as you can see. Harris floats ahead, Loader. Oes to Harris. Harris from the point. In the corner, forces the feed for Loader, and he threw it away. A bullet found low.
Two turnovers already for Alabama State. They're not handling the ball very well starting out, but they are a notoriously so slow-starting team at times.
Wayne Larrabee, Phil Snow, and Bill Jackson, court side, and I believe a foul coming up. Clayton Harris played Dave Fedica a little bit too tight.
Take another look at it. You see Clayton Harris with the pressure on Dave Fedica. Fedica trying to go down the sideline. Harris wouldn't give him any room. He got charged with a foul. There you see some of the Aggie fans.
Number 24 is Jeff Wilson on the inbound. Triggers to Fedica. That's King on the left side. Jackson's number 4 on Loader. Best matchup of the tournament. The rebound, Greg Oes. And Oes will take it out, averaging 8 points in this tournament. In the corner, Forston. Yes. 4-2. The Aggies have that 4-point lead, sliced to 2. Hornets press to the backcourt. Cameron out of the attack. Big Ray Franklin breaking it across. This is Fedica number 12. Franklin's up high. The backdoor feed to King.
I see Andre King.
4-point advantage again for Cameron. The lead pass overshot the target. Mel Creighton couldn't hang on to it from the backcourt.
Alabama State definitely cold starting this ball game. They've made 3-4 errors already.
We are a full 3 minutes into this first half of play. Alabama State trailing by 4. Franklin chases down on the left side to Cameron. the bullet to Jackson didn't quite get there, but Wilson picks up. King on the left wing. The bounce for Franklin, and again, Wilson trying to cover up for the mistake. Can't do it this time. A look at James Oliver on the Alabama State bench. Very calm and cool, coach, most of the time, Bill.
Bill Graham sitting with him, a guy who played on those great Kentucky State teams here in the early 70s.
Hornets working around. Fortson on the move through the lane. Good move by Fortson in heavy traffic, and he cuts the disadvantage for Alabama State in two.
Two goals out of four tries for Fortson. He's starting out hot and the only scorer for the Hornets right now.
Aggies will try it again. They've been receiving pressure in the backcourt and a break to the Aggies.
I've been here a long time, huh? A week on the road.
Dave Bedica, number 12 for Cameron, working against the Clayton Harris. Up high, Wilson. King on the left wing. Guarded by Greg O. Holds right out of him. That is Shirk, in fact. Wilson's number 24. Straight now to get Wilson. Bedica inside. Wilson with the force.
Jeff Wilson has to hit from outside to the Aggies as he has all tournament long.
Again, the pressure in the backcourt by the Aggies. Both teams pressuring full court. Cameron leading it by four. Hornets on the attack. Harris, the bounce for Loader, working at a soft angle. Down low, Fortson. Jackson the rebound. Good position on O's, and O's bumps into the backcourt of foul call.
I think it's the foul went the other way, didn't it? Let's see.
Foul went against Jackson. Elbowing foul on the backcourt.
You see it right there.
First, second on the Aggies. Hornets on the attack, trailing by four. Loader in the corner. Inside pass to Jennifer Fortson, batted away by Franklin. This is King on the right wing. Cameron with the transition into the offense. Franklin down low, the turn. Good position by Loader on the rebound in front of Jackson, and the Hornets are back the other way. O's pulls up on Bedica, couldn't make it go. Hornets off the rebound, this is Harris. Franklin has position on the boards, and Jackson clears it.
Alabama State cold here early, but Cameron's defense probably has something to do with that. This is the first seeded team that Alabama State has faced here in the tournament this week.
I have them for two of ten shots right now, so they are definitely having an off night so far.
Foul coming up on Greg O's.
Take another look at it, Dave Bedica, with the pass over to Leroy Jackson, and Jackson just couldn't get away from O's. O's with the holding foul.
Number three on the Hornets, first on O's. Aggies on the attack. Leroy Jackson is down and a 20-second injury. Time out, I'm sure, will be taken.
Jackson looks like he caught an elbow in the stomach, knocked the wind out of him. He wants a foul called on someone. Talking to referee Jim McDaniel. See Jackson pointing to someone over there.
Well, Leroy apparently will stay in the ball game, but he'll debate the issue with one of the officials.
The replay
here. You see Jeff Wilson throwing it in from over in front of the Alabama State bench. Now watch the lower part of your screen. You see it. Jackson going down. You see him catch it there very well.
Clayton Harris caught him with the elbow. Bedica off the inbound. This is Franklin on the lead to Wilson. Very good. Very good. Aggie played it by six, and again pressure in the backcourt. Hornets break it across. Greg Owens. Clayton Harris. Loader down low. Loader baseline. Now the lead is cut to four. Again, the Hornets are pressing in the backcourt. Franklin has his pass batted away by O's, and Harris picked up. Two quick points, and the Cameron lead of 6 moments ago is down to two. This is Wilson, number 24. Direct traffic. Wilson backing in. Jackson. 4 points again, the lead for Cameron. Harris moves it up to O's. O's double teamed. Down low, Fortune with the turn. Moves inside, but Fortune has a decent touch on the ball.
He certainly has, and he's played better in this tournament than he has all year. He's really come on strong.
Cameron by two, and with the ball, Medica on the drive. Jackson, the rebound. Again, it won't go, but a foul call. Carl Fortune hit with his first personal foul. That's the fourth on the team.
One of the few times the Aggies have had a chance to break here early. Medica missed the first layup. Leroy Jackson tried again. Fortune came in there, hammered him on the arm. And a foul call on Carl Fortune.
Fouling coming down. Substitution into the Cameron lineup. Kimball reports on, and Ray Franklin will get a rest. Franklin has one personal foul.
Well, Kimball's had a fine tournament for the Aggies coming off the bench.
Cameron on the attack, leading it 12-10. 13-14 to go, where first half of play. This is King, number 15. Worked over by Greg Olsen and White. Kimball on the left side. Jackson on the wing. Kimball had the rebound, and now Wilson. Wilson again. Did it count? Yes, it does. Nice play by Jeff Wilson, followed up his own shot beautifully. We're going to see it again on the replay. The team missed the first shot. It comes off the board. Wilson gets it again. Jeff Wilson. Nice move. Underneath. Lays it off the board. Draws the foul. He's got a chance for a three-point play. That was the third personal foul on Creighton Smith on the team. He has 7 points in this game. 15-10. The lead is 5 for Cameron over ASU. Clayton Harris. From the point, Loader has room. Rebound, fought for, and running out of real estate on the far side, Mel Creek. It'll be Cameron basketball. Robert Phillips reports on for Alabama State, replacing Mel Creek, to leave with 2 personal fouls. Got a look at Phillips, number 34 moments ago. Now this is Dave Etiquette.
Fine young freshman, he's good on the board.
Had a good tournament, too. King off the weave. 7 points for Cameron, the lead, and that's the largest for the evening. Loader has the move. Loader again, can't make it go. Harris in the lane. This is Ose, bumped by Medica. You saw the foul clearly. On Dave Medica, that'll be personal foul number one. Third on the team.
We'll look at it again, and we'll see that Alabama State is getting it off the board, but they can't get in the hole. And the foul there.
This is the coldest Alabama State's been all game.
Yeah. Dave Medica. He'll do that foul. Now the inbound. Down low, Fortune can't make it go. Rebound is pried loose by Harris. Ose gives to Harris once again. Directing traffic. Phillips. Back to Harris. Worked over by King. Believe Ose. Alabama State on the attack, trailing by 7. Hornets taking their time. Fortune. Nothing but black jerseys for the rebound. As a matter of fact, Leroy Jackson and Jeff Wilson were battling for it.
Stone cold. They have 5 shots at it that time. Didn't get it in. That's good down.
Wilson from the point. Tried to play it to Kimball and threw it away. Kimball was cutting toward the basket. The pass was geared toward the sideline. We've got a break to the action off the interview. Bill Jackson from TV6 in Wichita Falls. And this man, Bill Snow from WSFA in Montgomery, Alabama. You're watching the Hornets of Alabama State on the attack, and they trail by 7. This is Clayton Harris, number 12. Fortson down low, trying to feed inside, and Ose was the intended target, kicked out of bounds by the Yankees. Harris found the inbound. Ose up high to Phillips. Harris back to Ose. Phillips, the freshman. From the corner, Loader. The rebound is looked away by Kimball, and the Yankees a chance to move on top by 9. Good-sized delegation from both sides out hand.
Thurman's leading scorers hit only 1 shot in 5.
Wilson, number 24. That's Medica from the point, number 12 in the dark jersey. Kimball on the left wing. Jackson up high. This is Jeff Wilson on the loose. Cameron leads it by 7. Leroy Jackson makes it up. Leroy Jackson starting to heat up.
He is quite a shooter from outside. Interesting that Loader is guarding Jackson.
10 and a half to go. First half of play. Hornets trail by 9. Phillips with the move. Everything's come up cold for the Hornets. Medica the rebound, number 12.
Many of those shots aren't even close either, Wayne. They're just off tonight. This is a very close start.
This is Jeff Wilson. Jackson up high. Started by Loader. Two candidates for MVP in this tournament, as still so much. Wilson to Medica. Give and go work.
Good here, beautiful.
Now the Aggies have got the game going now. Hits it man-to-man.
The lead is 11 for Cameron over ASU. Clayton Harris, number 12. Off the pick by Fortune. This is Ose, number 15. Up high, Loader. Inside of the lead, Fortune, and we got a call.
Traveling ball on Carl Fortune.
You're watching some of his feet as he receives the pass now from Kevin Loader. There it is right there. And he's called the travel.
21-10 our score. Cameron leading ASU. Aggies on the attack. Jackson on the left wing. Wilson number 24. That's King with the basketball now. 9:26 to go in this first half. King has the step on Owens. The loss of the handle gets it back.
Well, you know things are going right for the Aggies. If you see that play, King off the handle, fell right back in his hands. He put it up and in.
13 points, the lead for Cameron.
Alabama State's had a long drive spell.
Smith.
They are really putting up some bricks, too, you know what?
Right up down low, it'll be Kimball for Cameron.
Here's the play on the tie-up. I can't see it, but there he is. He's got him right there, and the ball's tied up.
Mel Creighton and Keith Kimball, and the pass controlled by the Hornets. Loader off the feed, stripped away by Medica, kicked out of bounds. They've had Loader all bottled up in this one so far.
He's working with that sprained left ankle. Obviously, it's lost some of his quickness, but he's going tonight because everything's on the line.
This is Loader, number 44. You see the touch. Probably the best shooter in the field. 23-12. 11 points the lead for Cameron. Wilson. Medica picked up by Jerome Powell now, number 24 for Alabama State. This is Wilson. Kimball on the left side, jumped out by James Smith. Jackson. King.
Andre King can play with those big guys under the board and get the garbage bucket.
Cameron shooting 8 of 17 so far, 5 of 16 for ASU, and another turnover there, their fifth.
Leroy Jackson hands to Medica. The other corner, King from deep. Nice block by Ose, knocked out of bounds.
Good job by Ose there defensively. King likes that shot. You see it on the
replay.
Here
comes Gregory Ose just touching the ball as it goes up.
Jackson as we resume.
Leroy Jackson again, he's heating up.
27-12 the score. Cameron leading Alabama State. Hornets on the attack. Loader at the baseline, has to get a foul. Rebound batted. Jerome Powell with the hustle move to the foul line.
Jerome Powell.
Powell cuts the deficit to 13. King trying to handle in the left-hand corner. King saves, but to the wrong side as far as Cameron's concerned. Hornets on the move. On the right side, a whistle on the play. Offensive foul coming up on Creighton.
Dave Medica got position that time on the lane. Creighton was barely in there. Got called with a charging foul.
We have 7.5 left to be played, and a timeout. 7.5 left to be played for a first half of play. Cameron on the attack. Alabama State presses in the backcourt again, but Franklin breaks it across for the Aggies. Franklin finds Wilson. That's Medica, number 12. Powell is out to get him. On the wing, Wilson, Franklin down low to Jackson, tipped away nicely by Carl Fortune. 6'5 senior, very quick inside.
Some of the Alabama State band, I believe, made it up for tonight. They haven't been here this week. This is their first game, I think.
Zeneca from the point, number 12. Again, Powell's on him. That's Wilson, bottled up by Ose. Looking for Jackson, couldn't find him. King out to retrieve. 7 minutes left to go. We are first half of play. Cameron leading by 13 and a 5-second violation. Loader was on King, and they'll jump it up in the Cameron end.
Kevin Loader, obviously, had a great tournament. An ankle sprain, as Phil said, has been giving him a little bit of trouble the last couple of ball games.
Off the tap, and let's see what the call will be. It'll be Cameron, or it'll be our Alabama State basketball. Ray Franklin was all set to inbound for Cameron, but it'll go to the Hornets. Alabama State trailing by 13. Powell on the right wing. And Smith up high. In the corner, Loader. Down low, the rebound. Picked away by Ray Franklin. The long lead for Wilson. Nearly ran out of real estate. King on the left wing. Cameron content to take its time. Aggies lead it by 13. Medica backing in. Franklin with plenty of room.
Yes, sir. Franklin will hit that shot if you give him room, and that big close man James Smith is laying off of him. He'll hit it every time.
15 points now, the advantage for the Aggies. Hornets on the attack. Quickly, Powell over the jump, rejected by King. Inside it goes to Ohs. Alabama State works it around. Ohs to Powell. Inside, Fortson with a tough move. Will it be offensive? It is an offensive foul, I believe, coming up on Fortson. We'll get another look at it.
Carl Fortson, watch him go for the basket and come down. The guy has position under him, and the ball doesn't go. It would not have anyway.
Second on Fortson. It is the seventh on Alabama State. 6:01 still to be played as we get a look at the Cameron bench, and the Hornets over the limit.
Nichols talking to Andre King there on the left, Dave Benica on the right. Sign put up by the Alabama State delegation here. The Alabama State very tight. They're putting the ball up hard off the glass. They just haven't settled down yet.
This is Ray Franklin. The lead is 16, and that is the biggest bowl of the evening. Franklin to make it 17 if he can. Loader is there to clear the boards. 30-14 the score. Cameron on top. Alabama State to the fourth court in a hurry. Powell can't hang on. In the corner, picking up Robert Phillips. This is Clayton Harris and a blocking foul on Dave Benica, who is down on the play.
See the foul coming here. Harris making a move, and he was moving into him and helped the guys not injured. Bad a collision there. Looks like he might have caught an elbow there in the stomach, knocked the wind out of him. We'll have to wait and see. May have hurt his knees holding one of them.
So the Aggies will have to make a change here, and they are taking Dave Benica off to the dressing room.
Well, that's going to hurt. Benica, their playmaker, quarterback on offense, their best defensive player, along with Jeff Wilson.
Kimball back into the ballgame for the Aggies, and he replaces the injured Dave Benica. Hornets will inbound at the baseline, Clayton Harris. Greg Oles back on, replacing Jerome Powell. Neither team has gone deep to the bench so far. The Oles off the inbounds. Kimball clears the board. Aggies have had position all night long on the defensive board. Wilson from the foul line of the hang move. Gets it count.
Nice move by Jeff Wilson. I think he's going to get charged with a charging foul. We'll watch it on the replay. Wilson going in. Big guy James Smith with position. Wilson will get the bucket, but the foul will bring it back the other way.
His first fifth on the team. 32-14. 18 points is the lead for Cameron. Alabama State on the attack. Loader on the right wing. That's a nice touch off the glass, Phil.
Kevin Loader's third goal of the night.
And moves it across, leading 32-16.
But he's three of only nine shooting, so he's having a definitely cold first half.
This is Wilson on the move. And the Hornets will have a break here. Phillips on the drive, and he's fouled by Kimball, but it will not fall.
Hey. Keith Kimball, not a smart play there. He had the open layup. Kimball trying to block it. Here's an example of the tightness of Alabama State. The first-year man puts it up. Easy layup, just will not go, but he does get the foul and will get a chance at the foul line.
Robert Phillips, 6'5", freshman, Selma, Alabama, fine player. He's going to be something for Coach James Oliver in the years to come. Phillips averaging 7 points for the tournament, 6.8 rebounds.
While shooting 75% free throws coming in, but he missed the first one.
Second by Phillips. It is 32-17. Cameron leading Alabama State. Aggies on the attack and the steal of the backcourt by Ose. This is Loader feeding to the corner. Phillips. Kimball the rebound. And the Aggies look to be, well, somewhat cautious on that break now. They're receiving good pressure from the Hornets. Extremely quick is Alabama State in the backcourt. King looking down low for Kimball. Finds Kimball. Slips away. Hits the bucket. 34-17. Cameron.
Nice control by Keith Kimball, able to get the bucket in without drawing the charging foul.
Clayton Harris up high. Loader trying to feed down low to Phillips. Hornets will do it again, this time from the sidelines. Ose off the inbounds, hands off to Harris. Smith the big man, number 50 at the top of the key. Ose had a pride loose by Jackson, but recovered. Now, Loader inside. Down low to Phillips, and he gets it in. 34-19. Cameron on top of Alabama State. Aggies moving it across. King plays forward to Jackson.
Without Fetica in there, they move Jeff Wilson out of the forward position to the other guard, and King will be the other guard.
Kimball down low. 36-19. Aggies continue to dominate. First half of play with 3:45 to go and a surprise.
Hornets known for their defense and not playing it very well in this first half.
Loader, number 44. Phillips again down low. And Kimball again with a rebound.
Nobody under the board.
This is King on the move. Aggies on the attack, leading at 36-19. Wilson wide open. Franklin with the rebound.
Oh, the Aggies playing well. Ray Franklin with good position, battling on the board with the dunk.
38-19, most impressive performance by the Aggies in the tournament thus far. Hornets on the attack, Rose off the pick. Rose looking on the right wing. You gotta figure the Hornets are going to come back here. Too good a team to stay this far down, and James Smith may start something with that bucket right there.
That's the big guy's first bucket of the night. They're definitely tight, pushing off there.
Ray Franklin guilty of a pushing move against Clayton Harris, and on Franklin, that's his second personal foul. It is the sixth team foul on Cameron.
When Franklin goes to put the ball down, that's not what the Aggies really need. He can't handle the ball that well against the press, but with Benica out, they lose some ball handling.
2:51 to go with Phil Snow from WSFA TV in Montgomery and Bill Jackson, TV 6, Wichita Falls, Texas, on the NAIA Basketball Network.
Dave Oliver, very important 2.5 minutes left in this half. They need to cut it down to within 10 or 12 to have a chance in the second half, I would think, with the fine defense that Cameron's played.
These are the Hornets on the attack, down low baseline. It won't go for Ose. Ball loose on the floor, knocked out of bounds, and let's see. Believe it'll go to the Aggies. Ray Franklin was the man I saw making the indication, though, so I held up. All right, the Aggies have the ball. They lead it 38-21.
Shooting percentages, Cameron 17 of 29 so far. That's better than 50%.
Double dribble the call on Jackson.
Alabama State is 10 of 31, less than 33% shooting
now. And the Hornets begin to pressure in the backcourt. That's beginning to take its toll. Loader on the left wing. Loader cross-court. Smith. Off the pick by Loader. Ose has a chip shot. With the rebound.
Ray Franklin wanted to look for the break that time, had nobody open.
Down low, this is Kimball, number 20.
Nice shot, nice touch from Keith Kimball.
40-21, the lead looms to 19 points for Cameron. Alabama State has lost one game in 31 games. And on the move, Clayton Harris able to connect. 40-23, 17-point lead for Cameron. Aggies have the ball. Wilson in the corner. Kimball. Wilson off the give and go. And will it be offensive? I believe it is.
Jeff Wilson, that would be his second charging foul. We'll get another look at it. Jay Smith coming in. Good position. He was set. Wilson just a little bit too anxious there on the layup. Couldn't get around him. He got charged with the foul. They have worked that give and go to perfection, though, tonight, you know? They really have.
James Smith at the free throw stripe, the 6'8 sophomore. Smith has played well in part-time duty. He was all-district a year ago, Phil, I understand, but couldn't crack the starting lineup this year.
The emergence of Carl Fortson is the reason for it, and he had some injuries, too.
Franklin, the rebound off the missed foul shot. Cameron Aggies on the attack with the lead and the ball. King. Franklin with the move, and it won't go. Franklin again. Rebound, Pride, loose down low by James Smith, the sophomore. Out of the backcourt, Harris, and a blocking foul coming up on King.
Andre King trying to get the charging foul, but he was moving in. He was obviously moving across right here. Took another hard blow, and an indication of the sportsmanship out there on the floor. Clayton Harris around to help him up.
Well, Clayton Harris at the free throw stripe. Harris in the tournament has shot at 64% from the line, 9 of 14. His first.
Gee, they are cold, aren't they?
No question about it. Been a long first half for the Hornets.
They're
minute 14
now
to go. Double teamed is King, and a traveling violation is called. Talk a little bit about that 2-1-2 press full court and the steel press, according to James Oliver, is a 1-2-1-1 press.
I don't know that I understand it, but I know it's been effective, and they do it all the time. It's just a way of life for Alabama State. Very effective in small gyms where they're screaming loud.
This barn a little bit bigger. Holds from the corner. Jackson is there for the rebound. Roy Jackson has been quiet tonight, but quiet in a pretentious way.
He can be quiet and still throw up 12, 14 points and you not realize it.
Kimball on the right side. Franklin is up high. Nearly threw it away. Long arms of Wilson, and he dribbles off his foot. He'll recover in the backcourt, and it'll be an over and back by Oliver.
Well, that pressure, Alabama State's really tightened up their defense here in the last 3 or 4 minutes, and it's giving the Aggies trouble. Of course, Dave Vetica off. We do not know his status as yet. I'll try to check on that injury and have it at halftime. Problem with the Hornets, though, is they can't make anything out of the turnovers right now.
35 seconds to go on the half. Fortson, no. Fortson again, yes. Good hustle by Carl Fortson.
Yeah, 8 points.
Cameron by 15. Wilson double team, nowhere to go. Fortson gets it off to Harris.
Oh, no. You can't miss that shot.
Please. Franklin on the rebound, bumping with Harris, and it'll be a foul.
Alabama State really cold. That is just an indication that they are tight and getting tighter. They just can't. They've had dozens of shots inside and they can't make it.
No foul called. The ball was tipped out of bounds. Long lead pass for Jackson. He is knocked to the floor by Fortson. Up with it is Loader. Loader loses to Wilson. To Jackson. 2-on-2 break. Jackson firing with 1 second left, and Loader with 3 at the buzzer. Foot of the middle. Jackson on the jump at center court, and the tap is controlled by the Hornets. Harris to feed Loader, and he can't hang on.
Not a confidence-building way to start the game in the second half. They're going to have to play well in the first 5 minutes.
When you trail by 15, it's imperative you get off first.
Right.
Full court pressure by the Hornets. Wilson takes up.
Dave Vetica is not out on the floor. I don't see him sitting over on the bench. It does not look good for Dave Vetica here in the second half. They may just be taking it up, though, getting him ready.
Wilson with a pass down low, tipped out of bounds, last touch by the Hornets. Jackson, the intended receiver, and Ray Franklin will trigger. You get a look at the Cameron bench.
Dave Vetica not over there, so he's back in the dressing room.
Fine defense on the inbounds by James Smith, and again, Franklin will have to try it. This is Jackson trying to feed inside, and James Smith, the 6'8 sophomore, backs it out of bounds. Smith is number 50, Franklin number 23, triggers to Wilson. Wilson not given a whole lot of room by Greg Oes. Wilson fires and glasses it in. 42-25, Cameron. Hornets working the point, Clayton Harris. Loader. Down low, it's batted up and picked up by Harris. Oes up high. Oes with the fade off the side of the backboard, and Franklin clears for Cameron. Less than a minute in, second half.
I think someone got a piece of that shot just as we went up.
42-25. Cameron leads it. Franklin up high. Down low, Kimball is open.
Oh, the Aggies really working that give and go. Just fantastic as they did in the first half. Alabama State left their back door open.
Loader trying to go down low to Smith, that's batted away and taken by Wilson. Ahead to Franklin, and he tight ropes right sidelines. Wilson in backcourt. In the corner, King from the baseline, the chip won't go. And right there to pick it off is James Smith. Hornets back the other way in a hurry. In the corner, baseline, Fortson. The cool shooting from the field continues for Alabama State. 44-25. Hornets trail of the Aggies. Move it across. Andre King. Jackson on the left wing. Franklin over to King. King trying to feed inside of the weave. Franklin's wide open. Now he's got Wilson. Blew the layup. Loader with the rebound. Hornets on the move. Oles had it tipped away momentarily. Loader down the gut. Blocked away by Kimball. Goaltending the call. Score the field goal.
Boy, Kimball got way up there on that one.
Full court pressure by the Hornets. Aggies looking to take it up. Wilson has to play ahead to King. Now it's a 3-on-2 break. King to feed to Jackson, and nicely done to Kimball.
Well, the Aggies are under control, obviously. Biggest lead in the ballgame, 19 points.
Hornets with Clayton Harris. In the corner, Fortson. Holds from the foul line. Big Ray Franklin. 46-27. Cameron with the lead and the ball. Jeff Wilson, number 24. Got it by Gregos in white. Franklin up high. Trying to dole it off. Kimball picked it up. Franklin. It continues. The domination by Cameron. Loader had it batted away and the foul is called. It is on Jeff Wilson. That is his third, first of the team.
We'll see Kevin Loader going to the bucket and the foul occurring right there on the grab, I think.
48-27, Cameron leading.
Point to be made that many of those shots that Alabama State has taken tonight that have gone awry have been contested shots. Cameron has played an outstanding game. You started to say it's been a big matchup, Wilson against Loader. Loader so far, only 8 points. He's averaging 26 for the tournament. Wilson's doing a good job on it.
Wilson had a soft ankle. Loader hits his first. It's a 20-point ball for Cameron. He could cut it to 19 here. We have 17:05 left to be played. Aggies again receive that full court pressure. Jackson moves it across. Aggies a little bit more confident against the full court press since they've come out in the second half. No doubt Lonnie Nichols talked about it at halftime. King put it down twice and it's called the double dribble. Alabama State trailing 48-29. Hornets on the attack. You're watching Greg Oles. Oles number 15. Loader spinning away from Jackson. Up high, Jerome Powell. Trying to hang on, Phillips. Powell in the corner at the baseline. Creighton hasn't rejected, but Oles is there to pick up. Oles on the move. Loader trying to chase down and does successfully. Now his jumper. Knocked out of bounds, Andre King. Contesting for that rebound with Robert Phillips, and King lost the deflection.
King felt he got knocked down over there under the bucket. But Alabama State has the ball.
Hornets triggering from the baseline. Gregos. In the lane, Phillips with the double pump. 38-31, Cameron on top. And again, the Hornets press to the backcourt. The Aggies move it across. Franklin to Kimball. They're trying to play to one of the guards, and do. Andre King, Jackson on the right wing. 16 minutes to go in the ballgame. Cameron leads it by 17. Jackson pounded by Powell at a timeout. Franklin on the inbound. Cameron with the ball and the lead at 48-31. Jeff Wilson, Franklin up high. Loader again. Rebound batted by Franklin on the pickup. It won't go for Phillips.
Fast break.
King ahead of the field. 52-31. Cameron leading Arizona. Alabama State. Andre King from the point. Powell did his shirt. King nowhere to go. Fourth. Rebound is battled around. And Wilson saves to Franklin, who is Robert. Nice
see it from Jeff Wilson that time. Franklin Ford calling the foul. We're going to see it again. I think we got fouled twice. The shot coming off there, going up for the rebound. Watch Wilson quickly right back into Franklin. Franklin open, draws a foul from Loder.
Kevin Loder hit with his first personal foul. That is the first on the team of the second half of play. And Ray Franklin, two shots of live. Franklin, 6'7 figure, averaging 7.5 rebounds in this tournament, has been plagued with fouls throughout the tournament, and in fact here tonight has three. And he's the worst free throw shooter on the starting five, which he's showing right here. Loder, the rebound, 52-33 Cameron over ASU. Quickly into the corner, the turnaround by Phillips, partially deflected. Franklin, the rebound to Kimball, chasing down and showing good speed to Ron Powell. Loder works the break back the other way. Nice feed to Hope. 52-35. It's down to a 17-point Aggie advantage. In the backcourt, Kimball, Frank Father, momentarily by Hope. Franklin has it, number 23, and he double teamed the foul of goal. Leaves are pointing to Phillips. Phillips will get the 34 foul. We're going to say it again. Ray Franklin looking for that one to give it off to. And Phillips got in there on the arm. Gets charged with the foul. First on Phillips. Second on the team. Not shooting a pair. Aggies on the attack with the lead and the ball. Goes to the five. Down low paint. Dribble for Kimball, or rather for Franklin, and a foul stall.
Alabama State's gambling now, doubling up and giving the oftentimes the opportunity under the bucket with the good pass. And Cameron, a very heads-up passing ball club, is spotting the open man.
Good point, Phil. They are gambling a lot on defense, sending two or three men out trying to get the ball in the forecourt. And again, they're leaving that back door open.
Ray Franklin, the first of a pair. 53-35, Cameron on top.
You talk about him gambling, but really at this point in the game, that's what they have to do.
That's it, right.
Franklin, 6'7 senior, New Orleans, Louisiana. The lead again is 19 points. 13 and a half to go in the ball game. Hornets on the downside have to get something brewing offensively in a hurry. Goes up high, Loder down low, and inside on the move, Phillips is fouled.
Robert Phillips making the move inside and is fouled right there by number 20, Keith Kimball, as he goes up for the shot. He'll have two at the line.
13 fouls. Phillips, the pair of flies. Takes a long look at the bucket, as you see. The bounce of the ball is not going in favor of the Hornets. Obviously here tonight. Apparently a violation. One of the Cameron ball players is over the line, and they're talking to Leroy Jackson.
Referee Jim McDaniel talking to Leroy Jackson. Jackson didn't like the call. Said he was standing on the lane there.
Good-looking freshman, 6'5", 200 pounds. Out of Selma, Alabama. He'll have another. 4-35.
When you're hot, when you're not, Wayne. Can't get anything going.
Evidence of that here tonight. Second up the line. Phillips cannot convert. 54-35. Cameron with the lead of the ball. Andre King. Right hand dribble. King looking for help. Finds it in Kimball. Batted away, stolen by Powell on a nice move defensively. He loses the handle, picked up by Phillips down the lane. Bowles chases down to the corner from the foul line, Powell. Down low, Phillips. The frustration beginning to show.
I tell you, Keith Kimball did a great job that time inside. The Hornets with the second, third try to shot. Kimball's been intimidating him inside all
right. There's a hand in almost every Hornet face when he shoots the ball, and that makes the difference.
54-35, once again our score, 12:44 to go. Cameron with the ball and the lead. Kimball's open to the baseline, and he's fouled. Carl Fortson picked him up way too late.
We're going to see it again on the replay. Kimball again open for I don't know how many times tonight, and then Fortson trying to recover. That's called for the foul.
The difference in this game has been the front lines of the two teams. Alabama State goes to the inside. They've done it all year. Tonight, they're finding the opposition very tough.
77% of the free throws tried for Kimball. And also, the reporting on for the Hornets.
James Smith is in. Melvin Creighton has returned to the lineup.
And Clayton Harris also back out. Kimball. 56-35, and the timeout all on the floor. Breakaway action, 12:39 to go. Hamlin with a healthy edge over ASU. This is the NAIA Television Network. ASU on the attack. Loader dealing on Jackson. Loader slips and falls and loses it. No foul call.
Kevin Loader moving to the baseline, and you will see him fall right there. No foul call.
King into the fourth court. Wilson, number 24. King had an ocean from spot 24. Wilson works from the point. Dave Benica has not played for Cameron in the second half. Jackson to the baseline. Benica out with a bruised knee. Jackson looking around, coming up on the 12-minute mark of the ball game. Wilson back to Jackson.
Cameron has hit 6 of 10 so far in the half. Many of them, of course, under the basket. Alabama State's problems continue. 4 of 18.
Jackson on the left wing. Aggies on the attack. Hornets playing a tough man-to-man. King down low. Kimball slipping away. And
well, the Aggies have just controlled it underneath. Offensively and defense.
23 points for lead for Cameron. ASU to the fourth court in a hurry. Inside, Smith with the wheel. Kimball, the rejection. That'll go, Bennett. Kimball is roaring, as you can see.
Kimball doesn't like that one. We're going to see it again. Kimball has done it all night long. Up, looked like a block.
Sure it is. Franklin from the point momentarily. Hands it to Wilson. They don't like Ray Franklin to handle it all that much. Wilson over to Jackson. This is King, number 15. Powell is on him. Blue fade down low, threw it away. Kimball apparently was not expecting it.
You know, Loader hasn't scored that much tonight, but neither has Leroy Jackson. Loader has done a great job defensively on him.
11 minutes left to go in the game.
Kimball's having quite a night off the bench. 12 points.
James Smith. Creighton with the double pump. Finally a call. How many? Four shots at?
Yep. Four times.
58-39. Cameron King on the drive, and it rolls home. I believe a foul is on Alabama State.
Maybe a two-shot foul, too. The Aggies on the break. That's what they like to do. Andre with the great speed gets the shot at Smith. Moving over a little bit late. Andre got the shot to fall. And he'll go to the line to try to make it a three-point play.
James Smith at his personal foul, number one. It's only the third on the Alabama State Hornets. And Drake King at the free throw strike. Rebounded to the Loader. Clayton Harris on the move. Off the feet, a nice play to Mel Creighton. 19 points is the lead for Cameron. 60-41. King quickly breaks it across. Jackson is wide open to the back door, but has to haul it in and lost through the stick.
Leroy had a tough time getting a handle on the ball there on the baseline. Lost it out of bounds.
10 minutes and 20 seconds left to go. Back into the Alabama State lineup. Where goes, replaces Clayton Harris. You see the combination. O's number 15, Jerome Powell, number 24. O's with the basketball. Loader from the left wing. Jackson on the break, and it's a two-on-one. King, Jackson.
Oh, Leroy Jackson.
62-41. Cameron in a rock. In the corner baseline, Creighton deals. Rejected, and a foul on Franklin. Blake Franklin got the ball, but the body also.
Melvin Creighton inside where it's tough working, and perhaps the body there on the foul. Looks like it was a clean block.
Franklin guilty of his fourth personal foul. That is the fourth on the team. Franklin has the seat on the bench, and Ron Michael.
number 35 of Fortuna.
There's Ray Franklin going over to have a seat on the bench. 9:54 to go. He's got four fouls. He's been in foul trouble most of the tournament, so that doesn't do for him.
Have a drink, Ray. A free throw strike. Mel Franklin. Mel hits his first. 9 points and six rebounds. Just average for tournament week. 6'6 senior, one of the few, will be leaving Alabama State. Second is good.
Melvin would like to have a good closing game. He has not had a good tournament.
62-43. Cameron on top. Michael with some problems on the right side. Double dribble is called. The Hornets have another shot at it. Trying to make it a ball game here with 9:48 to go. Down low, feeling it. Nice move. Mel Franklin. Strong move inside. 62-45. Aggies on top, receiving full court pressure. Wilson breaking across. King is in the corner. Kimball, number 20. Rebound. Quick. Brakes is coming to life. On the lead, and Howell could not hang on.
Took his eye off the pass just before the run. Looking inside for somebody else.
Again, full court pressure. Cameron with the healthy advantage over Alabama State. King on the move. The feed, Michael Chipshot. Jackson off the air ball. Down low, the rebound guarded by Phillips, and the Hornets are on the run. This is the type of game we expected in the first half. Double team on O. Foul called on Kimball, I believe. No, it is on a game.
Here's the double team coming now on Greg O's and King. Foul trapped right there. Are we in the bonus? No. Still not in the bonus.
Five team fouls on the Yankees.
Ricky Bull now in the lineup for Cameron.
Down low, looking for room. Brayton Horse, no. Tap by Phillips. Clear. 62-47. 15-point lead for the Yankees. Those of you in the Texas, Oklahoma area will remember the Yankees nearly blew a lead in a semifinal game. Having trouble getting across.
They don't have Dave Medica in there. Ray Franklin is out. And they've got Ricky Bull, who has not played that much. But he could be a factor here. Alabama State has played with nine, and Cameron has played with less.
Oh! There it goes. 62-49. Alabama State coming back. King on the move. Can't handle it. Batted away by Loader. Chased down by Rose for Loader.
That's goaltending.
Break in the action. This is not surprising. Alabama State is too good to be had. So long. 64-51. Aggies lead. Covering Alabama. Alabama State making a run on what is beginning to look like a tired bunch of Cameron Aggies.
Alabama State prides itself in their conditioning, Wayne. They like to think they control the last 8 or 10 minutes of the ball game. It remains to be seen if they can take out of this hole, though.
This is Clayton and Kramer. 64-53. Cameron. Aggies break it across. Wilson with an angle. Nicely blocked by Oles. Wilson gets it back. Oles is in his face. Legos on the move. Double for Wilson. He's put it out of bounds. Off his knee and out of play.
Can't miss those opportunities. They're trying too hard. Trying to make it happen too quick.
64-53. Cameron on top. King. Number 15. Franklin is back in the ball game, number 23. This is Andre King. He got a whistle. Offensive foul coming up on Cameron.
Let's see who it's on. Jeff Wilson charged with the foul.
Number six on the team, four on Wilson.
Now it's Wilson and Franklin, both with four fouls, and still a lot of time left.
Hornets to the forecourt. Jerome Powell down low, baseline, Creighton, his turn. Kimball is there, had it batted away by Leroy Jackson, and now Jackson recovers in his trap. Wilson off the outlet. Aggies by 11 with the ball. King. Franklin out high. Franklin directing traffic. Wilson gives up the dribble too early. Inside of Franklin, trying to shovel baseline. Batted away nicely by Owens. On the feed, foul. Wilson had to let him go. 64-55. Down to a 9-point Cameron lead. Feed ahead to Kimball, over to Jackson. Jackson will try to slow it down. Aggies trying to hang on. Hornets are making the run. Kimball in the corner is double team. And a foul.
Well, they had Kimball over there. The sandwich. We'll see it again.
Number 34.
Foul on one side. Stokes on the other. And they finally. They've been going to straighten under the basket for the last three or four chances.
You get a good look at him right there. 2 points. And Creighton looks for a three-point play.
Franklin has not played hard with four fouls all tournament long. He's got himself in a position where it's easy for the official to call a foul on him, and he did that time, so he's gone with 5:46 to go.
King back into the ball game, replacing Ricky Bull in the camera lineup. Alabama State. 64-58. It's down a 6-point timeout on the floor. By action, Lonnie Nichols and Cameron want to talk it over. 5:46 to go on this one. Cameron leading Alabama State 64-58 on the NAIA Basketball Network.
To news that nobody else can match.
Alabama State has outscored Cameron 17-2 in the last 5 minutes. The one Cameron field goal was a goaltending call on Loader. King to the fourth court for Cameron. Aggies lead it 64-58. Michael, number 35, double team. The Michael looking for room. Wilson, number 24. Back to Michael on the wing.
Yeah.
Down low, set up for Jackson, batted away, not out of bounds, flash cut by the Hornets.
Well, the Aggies need a bucket here. They haven't scored in quite a while.
10 of 19 for them in the half, so they have cooled off considerably. Alabama State's improving, 14 of 34.
Jackson, over to Wilson, number 24, Jeff Wilson. 5 minutes, 15 seconds to go. The lead is 6 for Cameron. Michael. Number 4 is Leroy Jackson.
Jeff Wilson was wide open under the bucket. They couldn't find him.
Andre King, Leroy Jackson. Jackson did not take the move. Aggies go a four corners of sorts. Ball batted loose, but Jackson is there to pick up. Jackson on the drive. The feet are coming. And finally breaks the string by ASU. Loader
can bring him back. He gets on.
Michael looking on the full court pressure and signals, I believe, for a timeout.
That may be a timeout they did not wish to spend. That's exactly right. Michael couldn't find anybody open. That Alabama State press has really gotten tough here in the last 6-7 minutes of the ball game, and Michael, an inexperienced ball player, but he did have enough presence of mind to get the timeout call.
Both teams back on the floor.
Barry Franklin out of the ball game. He ended up with a total of 13 points, 5-9 from the field, 3-6 from the free throw line, 11 rebounds, 5 assists.
Kimball on the inbounds, number 20, triggers to Wilson, 24. Floats it ahead to King, throws it across. Andre King, cross court, Kimball, top of the key. Cameron on the attack with a 6-point lead. Michael on the left wing. Michael double key. King is over to the baseline. 2 more points. Eight-point Aggie lead. The Hornets quickly to the fourth court. Powell giving up the dribble. Forts it. Oh, couldn't make it go. Loader with a tap. Loader again. He's spinning. 1-2 and gets it. 6 points. Again, the lead for Cameron.
16 points for Kevin Loader. He's warming up.
Aggie's able to break the pressure a little bit more easily now since that timeout. King to Michael. Now, Luke Kimball.
So many times, Keith Kimball has found himself wide open underneath. There he is again. He came up with an easy bucket. Loader way too late to go.
70-62 our score. Cameron leading Alabama State.
The Hornets may be a little too aggressive in doubling up on people and leaving people open under the goal.
Baseline, Loader. Jackson, the rebound. Cameron basketball. Aggies by 8 and trying to hang on. 3:20 left to go. Hornets again gamble offensively, and it works. Greg O. goes on the move. In the corner, Loader from the left wing. Loader makes it a 6-point Cameron lead as Alabama State continues to charge back. 3 minutes left to go in the game. Cameron with the lead in the ball. Michael is open from the right side, does not want to shoot. Jeff Wilson. Leroy Jackson double teamed. Michael is the open man at the point. You're watching from the baseline.
They're spreading it out now. Lonnie Nichols standing up across the way, telling him to get that four corner, spread him out.
Jackson penetration, Kimball on the drive. 8 points for the advantage for Cameron.
Kimball now with 20 points for the game.
He's the star of the show, 12 of them in the second half.
2:20 to go. Down low, spilling away. Creighton, and they got a foul call. It is on Kimball.
You're going to see Creighton dribbling around and Kimball reaching in and really clotheslining him there. That is what you call a foul there, I'll tell you.
Both teams in the moment hitting situation. The words being exchanged. Position being sought.
I don't think they like the way Kimball gave the foul that time, but Kimball, after Drake got inside of him, just decided, hey, let's make him shoot him at the free throw line.
Aggies are over the limit. So are the Hornets.
I do think it's been a little rough. I think the looseness of the calling this whole week may be culminating now.
when all the marbles are down.
We have 2 minutes, 18 seconds left to go. Hornets make a substitution, Clayton Harris into the ball game, replacing Robert Phillips. More quickness, no doubt, the aim of Coach James Oliver. Mel Creighton at the line. He can cut it to six if he connects right here. Long look at the rim. Alabama State back to within six. Timeout on the floor. 2 minutes, 18 seconds left to be played. Alabama State trailing 72-66. Wayne Larrabee with this Alabama State team to play with the Division I powers out in Alabama, according to many. And we have seen evidence of that this week. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Cameron. Wilson. Clayton Harris made the play. Wilson couldn't hang on.
Jeff Wilson couldn't believe that call. Alabama State now with a chance to cut it to four.
It'll be Clayton Harris on the inbound. Harris looking. Loader in the corner. Jackson is out. Loader trying to go inside. Plays it back outside to Ose. Ose with some penetration to the top of the key. Now down low. This is Creighton. Good fake. And he's fouled. Believe it'll be on Kimball. The indication we get is Keith Kimball, his third.
Melvin Creighton has really become animated in the second half of play. He apparently has gotten his confidence back, and he believes he can move with the ball into the basket. And he has been going to the bucket, either getting the shot or drawing the foul the last several times.
Hornets have been astounding in the last 10 minutes of play in the second half. They have charged back from a 23-point deficit. Mel Creighton, 6'6 senior at the line. The lead is down to five for Cameron.
Unusual shot, but effective. Almost throws it behind his ear. Watch.
One out of two. 72-67. Cameron leads it. 2 minutes left to go in the game. Wilson double teamed. Wilson looks for help. King on the sideline. Throws it toward the backboard, and it hit the backside.
Andre lost his head on that one. They had him pinned along the sideline over here, and he just threw it up for grabs.
We have a minute 52 to go, and finally this game has lived up to expectation. This is Jerome Powell.
Saving some time, allowing that ball to roll into front court.
Creighton down low. This time Wilson takes away. Creighton, in his frustration to get the ball back, is called for the foul.
Probably a good foul given up by Creighton that time. Because Wilson and the Aggies had to break wide open. They had it 3-on-1.
We'll see it again. Trying to move inside, loses the ball, and then trying to get it back. Fouls number 24, Jeff Wilson.
Jeff Wilson of the free throw stripe, a 6'4 senior, averages 14.5 points per ball game in the tournament, has had a solid tournament, Bill Jackson.
Jeff Wilson is probably the best all-around player on this Aggie club. He'll get the vote for our opponent.
1-1. It's his first. 6 points. Again, the lead for the Aggies. Minute 45 to go. He can make it seven. Alabama State from left to right across your screen.
They have to score almost every trip now.
Powell. Loader in the corner. Powell. Creighton down low.
Need to get a shot off.
Creighton baseline. Had no room. Lost it. Knocked out of bounds by Ron Michael.
Aggies playing good defense. They're not letting her get an easy shot in there.
Timeout on the floor.
Tonight, they just really hadn't been pushed. And then suddenly, when the pressure got on, they went up to it. But they really rallied, so they have nothing to be ashamed of. I'm glad for that, no matter how this thing turns out.
Hornets on the inbound. They stack up as you see across the lane. Inside, Creighton.
Good move inside. Pulled Kimball off him and then made the shot.
Minute 22 to go. Wilson over to Kimball, back to Wilson. Wilson wheeling out of the backcourt. Hits the deck and recovers.
Oh, King. Jeff Wilson, a great job of getting the ball back.
King has it slapped away, but it will be Aggie basketball. 69 seconds remain. Aggie 74, Hornets 69.
Boy, you think these guys aren't under the pressure.
It's rough out there.
How many times in an athletic life do you come this far? Inbound to Kimball on the foul immediately.
That's what Alabama State has to do at this point. Only a minute seven to go, down by five. If they can't come up with a steal, they pretty much have to try to foul and hope that the Aggies will miss at the line.
Jerome Powell, number 24 for Alabama State, guilty of the call.
He's went and asked several times for the two-shot foul, but didn't get it.
One-on-one opportunity.
Well, these are big ones.
6 points the advantage for Cameron. He can make it seven, and very difficult on the Hornets. 76-69, 65 seconds remaining. Hornets down. Inside Creek, who's done it so often in the second half. 6 points, again, is the margin at a timeout on the floor. 76. Guard the inbound, I should say. We got a quick look at Lonnie Nichols. 58 seconds remaining, as you can see.
Aggies have the choice of which side of the bucket they want to throw it in from. Kimball wants it from the right side.
Kimball gives to King. King looks up court. Ahead to Kimball, to Wilson, and they break across with relative ease. Kimball, down low Jackson, and he fouls.
Well, that's a foul that Clayton Harris had to give. Jackson, wide open underneath, would have had the easy bucket. You'll see it again. Kimball saw him open, good feed.
Good shot foul.
He comes in from behind. Jackson will go to the line for two.
49 seconds remain. Leroy Jackson can take two steps to putting this one away for his club. This is the first.
Jackson has not had a real good game here in the final scoring-wise. Only 11 points tonight.
Hits them both. Holds on the rebound. Hornets trail by five. In the corner, Harris. Down low, Creighton. 37 seconds remain, and the lead has been sliced out of 376-73. Cameron offense against Huron. We're pressing the point with starters in their first two off the bench. Had to play quite a bit. So they, too, may be a bit tired. But fatigue doesn't enter the mental picture at this point, I would not think. 37 seconds left to go. You go for it with whatever you have left. Kimball triggers on the inbound to the baseline. Creighton guards. And Kimball can't find anybody open. Calls for a timeout.
Alabama State playing tough. With the press, won't allow him to get the ball in. That's the second time now in the 1 point.
But they've just come back to dominate the final 10 minutes of this ball game. 37 seconds remain. Cameron on top by three. Chat of defense from the Alabama State crowd. In the backcourt, a foul coming up. Clayton Harris.
Question is, will it be a one or a two-shot foul? Let's see it again. Jeff Wilson with the basketball, and Harris coming way on the top, hammers him on the arm, and I believe it will be a one and one.
Cameron fans don't like the call, neither does Coach Lonnie Nichols.
That's a call you don't often get, you know?
One and one opportunity.
Strictly a judgment call on the official's part.
Big one here.
Jeff Wilson up the line. 4 points is the edge for Cameron. He can make it five with 35 seconds remaining. It is a 5-point Cameron lead. Hornets quickly. Clayton Harris ahead to Powell. A pass and headed for Rose, and that could cost him the ball game.
Well, Powell lost his head a bit. That one hurt.
29 seconds remaining, 78-73. Cameron over Alabama State. Inbound, batted out of bounds by Loader. Last touch by Loader on a nice defensive move right in front of our microphone. 28 to play. Kimball the inbound. Wilson, lead ahead for Michael. Kimball.
That'll not do it.
80-73. Alabama State trailing and Loader. 80-75, and the final timeout is taken by Alabama State. 13 seconds remaining. Cameron leading Alabama State. 76, 80, 75. We've seen a Jekyll and Hyde story here tonight for the Hornets. Phil Snow, awful first half of play. Just playing awful. Probably the worst they have played all year.
Yeah, not much improvement in the first 10 minutes of the second half either. It was just here in the last 10 minutes or so of the game that they came to life. I think let's take a look at that last scoring play again. Keith Kimball has had a bushel of these baskets right underneath, and you see him here with the dunk. And unless the Hornets can come back with some kind of miracle here in the last 13 seconds, that one is the icing on the cake.
Fred and Ray Michael with a great play feeding off there, too.
13 seconds left to be played. You see Alabama State. They're set to go. What a job Coach James Oliver has done in helping this ball club keep its poise, making it finally play to potential later in the second half, but perhaps too late. Cameron trying to hang on physically and mentally. Kimball on the inbound. King will break away, and we got a whistle. Greg Oles guilty of the foul.
You know, you talk about the great job James Oliver has done. Lonnie Nichols, on the other hand, who brought his team last year 36-3, and it's tough to bring a team back when everyone expected you to, and everyone's pointing for you, trying to knock you off, and they've come back, and right now they're 12 seconds away from a national championship.
Up here this week, I've heard the name Lonnie Nichols mentioned on several major college openings in the coaching ranks. King hits his first, and that makes it a six-point lead. Hornets are out of timeout. 82-75, Cameron. Cameron wants a timeout. You see the story. Cameron with the 82-75 lead, 12 seconds left for all intents and purposes. It's over.
Well, the Aggie fans across the way getting ready to flood the court. They're ready for a celebration. Coach Lonnie Nichols talking to his team, telling them just to calm down. We've got 12 seconds, guys, to run off the clock, and it is partying a full night long.
Cameron's fifth man is on, and this has to be the most joyous occasion for them of the season.
Well, James Oliver wanted to bring his team here and win the national championship. He was ranked number one the last 3 weeks of the season. He's a dejected coach right now because I think he feels that 6 points is 7 points is a little too much to overcome.
The inbound to Loader, 10 seconds remaining. Loader, rebound King, 7 seconds to go. King trying to stay loose and is hit from behind. Clayton Harris stops the clock with 4 seconds remaining. Harris.
Well, the Aggies starting to celebrate. Take another look at it. You see Andre King coming out with the basketball, and all the Hornets can do now is just foul and hope for a miracle, but it's pretty much over now. 4 seconds to go, and Aggies is adding a little bit of icing on the cake.
King up the line.
Cameron has had one national championship in the school's history. That was when they were a junior college in 1962. They had that in football. So for a four-year university now, this is their first national championship in any sport.
You see the Cameron supporters about to jump out of the floor. 4 seconds standing between Cameron and a national title. 84-75, here is the lead. Oh, plays down low. The final bucket of the ball. Celebrating an 84-77 championship victory over Alabama State. Cameron from Lawton, Oklahoma wins the 1980 NAIA basketball championship. And with Bill Jackson is Coach Lonnie Nichols. So let's get on to Bill.
The victorious head coach of the Cameron Aggies, Coach Lonnie Nichols. Coach, it was tough. You had to hold on at the end, but that national championship is yours.
Well, that's true, and we're very glad to have it, Bill. We had us a big lead, got in foul trouble. They put a tremendous press on us there late. We couldn't handle the ball real well. But we did come out victorious there, and I'm very pleased for the kids' performance, the support we received from Wichita Falls and you people. The Lawton people have been great to us, Southwest Oklahoma, North Texas, and we're very pleased to bring a national championship back to that area for this year.
Aggies came out hot. Alabama State was cold. I knew you were expecting a rush from the Hornets in the second half.
Well, that's true. You know, there's no way you blow that bunch out. They're too good. They have a great ball club. They got some great people, and we were just fortunate to hang on and win.
Coach, great season. You came back from last year 36-3. You're disappointed to lose in the quarterfinals, but you came all the way.
Well, that's true, but we got some experience. We were able to come up here, play three games, see what it was like, and I think that's what pulled us through this week.
It was a great season. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, that's what Cameron coach Lonnie Nichols has to say. A lot of partying going on in Kansas City tonight. Wayne, back to you.
Okay, thank you very much, Bill. Phil Snow, a look at the all-tournament teams.
Two guys from Alabama State, two from Cameron made the team. DeRoy Jackson and Andre King, they played well tonight for Cameron. Carl Fortson and Kevin Loader of Alabama State on the first NAIA all-tournament team, along with Terry Dupree, the fine guard for Huron, South Dakota.
Again, the final score, Cameron defeats Alabama State 84-77 to win the 1980 NAIA Basketball Championships. Special thanks to our director, Larry Magrill, assistant director, Dan Wheatcroft. Our technical supervisor has been Will Mistel. The camera is being run by Gary Lakey, Don Geist, Rembert Young. Our audio being handled by Larry Rempe, Slovo John Collinson, floor coordinator Alan Ball, and associate directors in Wichita Falls, Karen Rogers and Clark Thomas. And Phil Snow from Montgomery, pleasure to work with you here tonight.
Enjoyed it, Wayne. We'll be back.
Phil Jackson. Congratulations, I guess, on behalf of Cameron. And a pleasure again to work with you all this week. Thank you very much.